In this video, we'll be discussing about Kubernetes volume plugin persistent volume claim. Now let's start from a pod itself. Now inside a pod spec section in the volumes, we have defined persistent volume claim and the claim name as demo PVC claim. Now it is referencing to the original PVC spec. Now PVC is persistent volume claim and it is a Kubernetes object. And here is a YAML file for creating a PVC. So the kind is persistent volume claim. In the spec section, we defined how much storage is needed, what is the storage class name, and what are the access mode. Now, whenever a PVC is created, the master control loop will look for the new PVCs and will try to find the corresponding PV and try to bind it to that. Now, what is a PV? PV is a persistent volume. Now, this persistent volume is the actual storage, basically the abstraction of the actual storage backend, and it is also a Kubernetes object. And in this, we define the storage class name, capacity, access mode. Now the persistent volume has to be created by the admin. Now it can be created statically or dynamically. Now if a storage class is present, then it is a dynamic provisioning, else it's a static provisioning. Now say that you have created a PVC and there is no storage class. So the persistent volume claim remains unbound. Now you create a PV manually. And once the PV is created manually, then the PVC gets bound to that PV. So this was the example of static provisioning. Now, in case of dynamic provisioning, we need to define a storage class. Now, in Kubernetes, there are different types of storage class that can be used and have different set of configurations. So you define the provisioner, you define the URLs, if it's NFS or cluster FS and so on. And based on that, when the PVC is created by the user, now the PV gets automatically created. Now, there are a lot of benefits to it. So we only have to define a pod spec, volume, and a persistent volume claim. Now, in the claim, user can define what storage is needed, what is the capacity that is needed, and the corresponding PV automatically gets created. And based on the reclaim policy, if it's delete, the PV also gets deleted once the PV is deleted. And if it's retained, then the PV is retained. And if it's recycled, then it again can be used by another PVC. Now, we have discussed a few concepts. One is persistent volume. Persistent volume is a Kubernetes object which defines the storage inside the cluster. And it's also the abstraction which is linked to, and it's also the abstraction which is linked to the external storage. Now, storage class defines what kind of storage will be provisioned when a PVC is created dynamically. And in case of static provisioning, we create the PV manually. Persistent volume claim is provided by the user. So user need not know the details of the PV or the external storage. So all these things are abstracted. So they just say, I need a storage of this much capacity with access mode of read write once, read only many, or read write many. And the PV automatically gets created. Now PVC is also helpful when a pod goes down and a new pod come up on a different node, then also it uses the same PVC because that's a Kubernetes object and it is separate from the pod lifecycle, and persistent volume claim and persistent volume have its own lifecycle. So that's how you can use persistent volume and persistent volume claim inside a pod, and you can define a storage class for dynamic provisioning. All these things are covered in more detail in the demo section, where I'll be showing you the static provisioning, the dynamic provisioning, and how you can create all these components. That's it for this lecture. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.